there was the question whether this function should be linear. And the theory of ADMM and most of application are developed when the constraint is linear with respect to both H jointly, X and Z. Okay. Pause. Pretty short for some to today. Yes? Not yet? Okay. Okay. Another candidate. Let's take better pen.
So the derivative of f with respect to x is this part is a transpose multiplied by a x minus 3. This part doesn't depend on x. This part, the derivative is y. And the last part is p multiplied by x minus that. So if we equal this to 0.
On only our standard notation is gradient of nabla x. Nabla x, yes.
Yeah. And so we can write it this way. A transpose a plus p. I multiplied by x is the best x. It's equal to p z. It's a transpose b plus p z minus y. We just write it. If we assume that this part is invertible, we have x star is a transpose a plus pi inverse multiplied by a transpose b plus z minus y.
I just check yourself. I have slides from Stephen Boyd's review paper. Is it what you got?
Yes.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much. Okay, and now we have one more challenge, even more interesting. How to minimize it with respect to Z? Just a second. I didn't use the right window. Let me get back our objective. Sorry. Page down. Ah, okay. I wrote down this what we have on whiteboard, yes? Okay, you have it on whiteboard. Already. Let's think what will be minimizer in Z if we are given X. What will be minimizer in Z? So. What do we have in Z, depending on Z? Norm 1 of Z plus linear term plus quadratic term, yes? And pay attention that all three terms are separable. Every component of Z comes as independent element in the sum. You see? What do we have here? What is one norm? It's sum of absolute value of components. What is y transpose x, okay, forget about x. Y transpose z, yes? Because x is constant. What is what y transpose? It's sum zi multiplied by yi. What is this squared norm? Again, it's sum of some expressions squared, where every expression is dependent. So you can think that you want to minimize only term depending on zi. Mm-hmm. And try to take this challenge now, if you are able. What would be minimum over zi? Minimum in zi of this expression. I ask you questions. Where is my friend? There. I ask you a question. What will be minimum in zi? What do we have here? Lambda absolute value of zi, yes, plus yi multiplied by zi. Plus, what we have here, rho by 2, xi minus zi squared. It even has its own term, it's called soft threshold. In theory of sparse representation, it's the most used term, the minimizer of this expression. And I even can give you a hint how to come to solution, because this absolute value, it's a little bit difficult. Think about zi positive without absolute value. Try to find the solution under conditions that zi is positive. And then with negative, maybe it will be symmetric. Separable. What we have here, if you will open sum over zi, when every term has this form, so if you want to minimize sum of variables when they are not interacting, it's enough to minimize in each one separately. This is nice thing about separable problems. Have separable problem, you're very lucky. It's easier to do. Did you do it?
Well, I just calculated the
class and let's see how our solution will look. Did you do it? Okay, good, please. Did you take a course on sparse representations? No? So, good. Okay, where is the good... maybe let's remove this. This one. Let's put camera. Let's move camera more close. Can you help to control it? And be sure that your pen is good. Just try it. No, it's not. It should be really good. You use it for video. Okay.
Let's assume Zi is positive first. The derivative of if Zi is positive is lambda in yi plus p.
שכחת להכפיל ונגזר פנימית.
So you, okay, you wrote down derivative, yes?
Yes, derivative if Zi is positive.
Okay.
So the solution will be...
Okay.
I don't understand. It's complicated.
This divided by p. Okay.
If we have Zi negative, just minus lambda. Decide between both of the solution, which is the minimum, we just assign, calculate what we get, take the better one.
I would not say that it's this is final decision, because okay, I would say this is a way to decision, and you and me should think again at home about making this part clean, but actually this gives us to an idea of soft thresholding. I can show you on another example, and this may close the loop. Assume I have some problem I want to minimize in x. So I wrote it aside in terms of other problem with very x. Assume I had lambda absolute value of x here, and what I know that if assume that a is positive, I have a quadratic function, and my absolute value term will move me to the direction of origin. So I know it in advance, in such record, that my solution should be or positive or zero. So I write expression for the solution, and I say that if A is positive, this is my expression, a minus lambda with sign plus. And if I draw the function, how this expression looks as function of a, so if a larger than lambda, so it's just if lambda is zero, so x is just equal to a. If lambda is larger than zero, we reduce lambda from a, but we never go to x to be negative when a is positive. So we have this kind of plot of our solution. This is for positive a. And one can easily see that for negative a, it's very similar. And that's why the name of this solution is soft threshold. You can alone combine this idea and what is written here and get to final expression, which Stephen Boyd wrote for us. Soft thresholding with index lambda divided by rho of the difference. So I leave it a kind of half open. I gave you full set of ideas, so that this is one dimensional problem that you are capable to solve. And the complementary part is after you did those two minimization steps that we are able to do analytically, then you update multipliers by standard formula for multiplier. And this, you come to really a popular and efficient method for L1, L2 norm minimization. Okay, we finished, and now the questions. So, actually, when you solve example, you have less questions. Okay.
Can you repeat the explanation you made just
now? To repeat this explanation. So, assume I had the problem of this type, yes?
Yes.
So, what? How this objective function looks? It has two terms. It has a parabola located at the point A, yes? And it has a linear term, and you minimize some of those two terms. First of all, it's easier for me to assume that x is positive, so I forget about absolute value, and I treat it without. But I know that the only thing from my intuitive consideration that sum of parabola plus this absolute value, it should be positive. It should be or something greater than zero, or if my penalty, absolute value penalty will be strong, it will be zero. This I know from my general consideration. So I derive the solution x is equal a minus lambda, but I put plus here. So I say this is right expression, but x is non-negative. So if this expression will be negative, I will substitute it by zero. You know the sign plus. Plus on variable says that if the argument is negative, then we substitute it with zero. And we get this kind of plot for positive A. But for negative A, the story is very similar. It's like symmetric. So I will not repeat it. So and this is so-called soft threshold. Okay. Any other question?
How does that relate to our Z? Why do we use this? I didn't really understand how you got to the expression.
You know, if you have general quadratic expression with x, say about that this is, if you have a function of quadratic function of one variable, you have absolute value plus some quadratic function. Quadratic function you always can express in this form. If you forget about constant term, which doesn't influence the minimizer.
Okay. But this is not the function you are trying to minimize.
It's this. Okay. it's equivalent. From that form, you can write down in this form, and then get solution.
But what happened to A?
You can say, what is A? Okay, you have a function, you have this function, yes? And I said that this function is equivalent to Z, 1/2 Z minus A squared.
Oh, okay.
Okay? You can easily say what is A from this function. Okay. You should only put in memory that it's an easily solvable problem of one variable and it's solved in this way. And the solution is this kind of problem. I hope that you will be able to get into with details by yourself. Okay. Okay, thank you very much. And as usual, who wants free discussion, you're welcome.